To use Memcache using the Java Native API, first you get the Memcache service. You'll need to import the Memcache service and the Memcache service factory into your project, and then you just use the getMemcacheService method on the factory to get the Memcache service. Then to put an entry into Memcache, you need a key and, of course, a value to put, and you just call the put method. And to get the value out of Memcache, you need to know the key and you just call the get method on Memcache service. If there is no value in Memcache with that key, then null is returned. Setting the announcement is something that we don't want to expose through endpoints. We don't want other people to be able to set the announcements for our application. So we use a servlet in this case and protect the URL for the servlet so that the app itself can set the announcement, but no one else can. Actually, developers for the application will be able to set the announcement, but no one else will. So you see here, I implemented set announcement as a servlet. It extends HTTP servlet and it implements the doGet method. So here's where I imported the Memcache service and the Memcache service factory. Here's where I get the Memcache service, and here's where I put the value into Memcache. Notice that this method doesn't set the response. So we set the response status to 204, which means that no response is expected. So if you come here in the browser, just stay on the same page where you are. All this method does is generate the announcement and save it in the Memcache. It doesn't return it. When you use servlets in an App Engine application, you need to configure them in web.xml. So here's the mapping I added to web.xml for the getAnnouncement servlet. So here the servlet name is setAnnouncementServlet, and then here is the class that implements the servlet. And notice that I put it in the servlet package. And then you map the servlet name to the URL where it gets called. So in this case, we're going to call the servlet by going to cron/setAnnouncement. I also defined a security constraint for my servlet, because I want to make sure that nobody except developers for this application can trigger the servlet. So I define the resource name and then the URL pattern that I'm protecting. Here I've specifically protected /cron/setAnnouncement, or I could just protect everything under the /crons path. And to specify that only admins, that is developers for the application, can trigger this URL, I set the role name to be admin. If I'd wanted it so that any logged in user could trigger it, all I would do is specify the role name as asterisk, but I don't. I definitely want to restrict access to admins.